person in the development of the sector. I am aware, and I have indeed participated in a lot of the consultations that culminated in this important Mombasa meeting. That consultation that took place in Nyeri, Nehru, Kisumu, Eldoret, Mombasa here and Nairobi, is the style of work that we want to encourage in SACCO. We want to encourage participation and consultation so that the sector moves in harmony. We are living in dangerous times. And if you don't know and you're not aware of what is happening, it becomes difficult to sit in SACCO. As a matter of fact, I would like to say that this country is moving towards that direction of consultations. In every respect, whether it is in national governance, institutional governance, I'm told even in schools, they are democratic elections for people, so that there is no imposition of leadership. So I'm really happy that the attendance is as good and as impressive as it is. Where you discuss the reporting mechanisms, SACCO wants to be consultative. Our consultative approach to regulation should ever not be taken as a sign of weakness. It's to democratize the sector, but also to be able to perform the duty that SACCO is endowed with by the law. All that I want to say is that we as SACCO are quite happy that the sector is moving in unison, that we are able to consult, you'll be able to express your views, and we'll be able to make consultations.
We contribute a lot, be it in the field of education, be it in the field of agriculture, be it in the field of health. That's a fact. And we always say that we have an X percent contribution to the GDP. But now when we are challenged to provide the statistical information that can be drilled down to the specific sector that we assisted, we end up with generic answers without proper data. So that's the genesis of the sectoral lending, so that we can be able to pinpoint which specific sector we've supported and by what figure, so that when the policy decisions are being made, somebody can appreciate statistically the contribution of the movement. What are we talking about in terms of sectoral lending reports? What we are saying is that we are giving loans outside there. We are giving credit to our members. So the sectoral lending is lending by financial institutions in sectors. You can even come down and say that you lend by purpose. You can say you lend in the agricultural sector, for instance, and the purpose for lending is, let's say, for example, coffee. I know we have generic ones. We have the normal loan, how normal it is, I don't know. We also have the health. We have emergency. So, but we are saying that we can now go a level down to now unpack in terms of the sector or in terms of the purpose. You know, banks have been doing this. The commercial banks have been doing this. And if you look at the stability report, you can be able to tell how bank funded the manufacturing. And this is why you'll appreciate that there has been a lot of debate in terms of the interest capping. The reason being, somebody could tell how were SMEs funded before the capping was done. There was a bigger pain. Now, how have they been funded now that the capping of the interest rates has been done? Then there is a bigger. Now we are told that at the end of the day of today, we need to submit a report as a movement which tells the policymakers the kind or the amount of money
that we issued towards funding a specific sector. I'll give you an example of a specific sector. Let's say they, as a movement, can I get an answer? We don't. Does it mean that we don't lend them? He wants to give me an answer that we might do that what I got now.
The truth is that traditionally, the SACCO has fewer sector areas which can be identified very easily, like education, medical hospital. But in most cases, we say normal law, development law, which is not specific. Therefore, it began to very hard.
These are from the licensed deposit trading SACCOs. So you ask this here. Deposits we have, loans we have, and the capital we have. What can you tell about this statistic? The first thing you can tell is that yes, it is true, SACCOs are giving out loans. Now I can open for the plenary so that we can be able to address the issues before I tell you the next stage.
Good morning.
Morning.
My name is Manuel from Temple SACCO, Nairobi. Just a clarification in terms of the effective date, which is 15 of April 2020. Does that mean then from January we need to start capping this application? Is that cover that passport?
Thank you so much. Good morning. My name is Charles Mubi from Yati SACCO. I think it's a fantastic approach. We need this framework. Anything that comes across to support us as SACCOs for purposes of influencing government policy, I think is most welcome. The only item perhaps we need clarification is, if I'm not wrong, this framework for now covers the DP SACCOs. So there's a big chunk of the non-DP SACCOs which will not fit into this framework for now. But for us to be able to meet the objective here is to influence government policy. We need to capture everything within the sector so that the numbers are actually, we can get the numbers. So perhaps we need clarification in terms of what the regulator is doing in terms of working with the ministry and another parties to ensure that we capture all the data in the sector. Thank you.
Mine is just a suggestion that indeed what we want first and even supporting from a senior SACCO. My suggestion is that as a model, it's important that as a board, we first internalize, understand this new model, and try to start with advocacy. Because we need our members to know the importance. Why? Because in most cases, we take things, if you look at our movement, members will just write for education because they don't understand really the purpose. So the first thing to me is to see how do we go through a board, make it a must, make it a very important item. Then we have a model of advocacy. How do we tell our members this news? What has come out? This is something that has been given by the authority. So that the members down there, take this serious, through our branch officials and others. So that at all times, that is something that has been given a specific importance to give those reports. Out of that, I'm sure we may have value for this particular, the intended value from the authority. So I think that is the best. Most of us may need, but we never give the importance that it's coming out.
There are two issues I may comment on. The first one is on the non-deposit taking SACCOs. Remember, the main objective of this is to influence the policymakers and also really to prove what impact we have in the economy. If you go to Vision 2030, the savings, the country wants to have the savings increased by 10%. When I was checking what the level we have on SACCOs, it is, I may be wrong, but it's around, the growth is 20%. About 20%. And if we are mobilizing 30%, you can see the impact. Even that mobilization of 10% as an economy is very low. If we can influence the 30% at 20, there will be a big push to achieve more than the 10%. Anyways, by Vision 2030. Now, we are talking of the sector, not a section of the sector. So, I think as much as we focused on the deposit taking, this thing has to be embraced by all the SACCOs.
To deal with governance issues, I think I've always said as a PS, and I've gone on record, and I have said that this sector, in the majority of cases, is doing very well and is doing an excellent job in looking after the money of its members. But as in any market, there are always a few who have gone astray. And that governance issue, we are working with ESCC to make sure that members' funds are actually protected. And as I've always said, cooperatives are private enterprises. They are member-based enterprises. But at the end of the day, there's an overriding public interest. And the government's interest is to make sure that members' contributions are actually safeguarded. That is the interest of government.
Report, I mean,
B1 and 2, there is a form just like the fit and proper test form which will be attached to this. We provide that so that that person completes, declares that, and like you do, commissioner of odds, and you as a SACCO will have to also certify the information given there is information you know. So that is what is said just before 3, we are talking of a nomination form. That person to express interest, once he's interested, then he has completed that form. 3, we are saying there could be other information that you might have. We'll be able to provide that where we have. That's just to, in case we have information, we have room to share with you. The most important is C4, where again we are emphasizing the issue of gender balance so that you are cognizant of that and equitable representation. But as we read through, you'll see how we endeavor to meet that. Going to 5, we remember the question of equitable representation. We interpreted that, and what we proposed therein is that because you are protecting deposits, then our view is that deposits will be a good indicator to actually achieve this representation, that is, achieve equity representation. And that is why we are saying the latest published SACCO exploration report, like the one that we have 2018, that's what we have used to categorize A and B. Those above 5 billion and those below 5 billion, and that these are the two categories. When you do that, as opposed to the 3 tiers we have, then we will, and since we are protecting deposits, then we are saying this will then give us a situation where we have above 5 billion based on 2018. We had 58.8 in terms of deposits. That's what all the SACCOs above 5 billion were carrying. That is 54, they had 54% in deposits, while those below 5 billion, category B, had the balance, which is about 45%. And therefore, that we felt is a fair distribution, so that you say category 1, then, as you see there, then we'll nominate 2, category B also nominates 2, and then you have the 4. So that's what we deemed appropriate. And you see, of course, the question of regional position comes in, but that's now you see how we are trying to.
Just a few clarifications that I had. Number one,
we have noted that the SACCOs are categorized into two, and that each category will bring in two, and that they will either use consensus or elections. The election is fairly clear because it will be done electronically. What confirmation or clarification we would seek is how the consensus will be achieved. How will we bring the category together so that they can do consensus, if that is the way?
It seems to be touching on B. Yes. It's like you are setting aside B and saying you can be an officer but resign upon being appointed by the CS. Is that the effect? Given the country, the provisions of the law, as it were, the wise person who drew this law and the regulations that time drafted what was there. And indeed, the other statutes of the compensation funds were in a similar version. So, and they have functioned anyway. That's why I agree with Hazina, chairperson, that yeah, it has worked. So we can borrow, and perhaps in that coordination, you can borrow from there. So with that, then our ask is that at a starting point, they say the perfection is the enemy of good. There's a sense of urgency to kick this, so our ask is that we validate this subject to the areas you have amended, you have proposed, then so that it will be communicated to you. Then it is when you communicate it, we'll indicate the timeline within which that coordination should happen, and that's the kind of, then the work will start. But it's important we start this process very, very urgent. So that's my ask.